message and singing that song, and I have to fully confess, maybe make Debbie cry as well. Your pastor came to you a broken man. Came to you a broken man. With no hopes, no dreams. But I'm still searching for him. The person you see here today is not the person I was 9 months ago. Nehemiah was weeping and mourning and praying. Where do you think I am right now? Still weeping and mourning and praying. There's no room in my heart for vision right yet. He doesn't know this, but I sat and wrote in my journal today to Jacob, my son, saying, where's my hope? Where's my dream? What am I doing here? Why do I share this now? Because every day I'm praying. I'm counting on Christ to carry me through. You know, the second week I was here, I walked in the church and they said, you know what happened to Doug Wyman yesterday? His wife committed suicide. Second Sunday here. You know how much time I spent with that man in the last 6 months? And he and I ended up in the family's house up the street two Saturdays ago. I'm sitting in their house, and he put a glimpse of souls with us, and we're ministering to a family whose son just killed himself in a house five houses up from here. I know some people have not been happy with my ministry, but I understand that, I get it. My heart burns for those people who are lost and suffering, who need Christ in their life. Lord, I need you. The church's one mission is to speak the truth, and that truth is we live in a world full of pain and sorrow and suffering, but we have a risen Savior redeemed, who lives again, who brings hope and blessing into the world. And it's our job to tell that to the people out there who don't understand. I want us to have a dream, a vision. He mentioned moving the church 50 miles away. That's a bold vision. Christ has a bold vision for this church. I don't have it in my head yet, in my heart, but we all together can get there. Christ lives. He lives, he lives, he lives. He's coming again. He brings healing on his wings. I stand in front of you. Debbie comes here every Sunday with the heaviness of our heart that you just cannot imagine. And he sustains us every day. And if he can do that for us, he can do it for everyone. He promises that. Whatever it takes. The only thing I can promise you is I will be here giving you my heart and my best. That's all I can do. And in so doing, I point to Christ and say, he is the reason we are here. Praise the Lord for what he has done for us. Praise the Lord for what he has yet to do for us. If it takes weeping and mourning to get there, then that's what we need to do. But joy and blessing and hope and healing are at the end. We cannot believe anything else. Thank you for your message today. I know we've gone long. Some folks may be hungry. Let us close by singing our hymn of promise, number 707. together in love and grace and forgiveness and ask God to speak his vision into our hearts. So go forth this day. May the Lord bless you and your family. May the Holy Spirit be alive in your heart. May you always do the things that Jesus would have you do. Amen.
Amen.